My name is Vladimir Mironov, and I know how to print human organ. The principal feasibility of organ printing technology was already proven, but there is, as in any technology, there is certain challenges and the problem. So one problem is we need a lot of cells, and we need a lot of aggregates. So in order to do this, we must develop what we call scalable biofabrication technology in such a way that you can create not just 100, but millions or even billions of aggregates. That's one challenge. The second challenge is when we finish our printing, our tissue is still a little bit fluidic, or we call this viscoelastic. So material property of tissue is not corresponded to material properties of real tissue. So we must design method of accelerated tissue maturation in such a way that surgeon can take this organ and surgically attach to pre-existing blood vessels. Of course, many people ask, what is a bioprinter? What is the essence of this technology? Bioprinter is basically a robotic device for dispensing biological material. It consists from variant of syringe, which can dispense material, and a robotic hand, which can move this syringe in all three possible directions. And of course, it's all controlled by computer and computer program. So this is the principle of bioprinter. There's already several variants of this printer: inkjet printer, dispensable printer. And one of the most exciting development in organ printing is that some people at first only dreaming about this, but now there's already several papers which demonstrate you can print tissue directly in operation room on the patients. We call this in vivo, because original idea was to build organ at first in vitro, in lab, in bioreactor, and then transplant. Now people thinking to print cells and tissue directly on the patients. For example, if you have injury of the bone, you can print bone immediately in operation room. And this is very important development, because it's move organ printing from advanced tissue engineering technology into a domain of clinical practice, and it became second generation of robotic surgery. And imagine if in the future you have some fracture or injury, you don't need to wait several months until somebody give you organ or bone or something. You just go to operation room, and in real time, machine, we call this clinical bioprinter, will print you, construct, and then you stand up and go home. So it will be a revolution in medicine.